Okay. For today, we're going to do something different. I made this little art journal. I haven't bound it yet or put a cover on it. I did bind it, but I didn't put a cover on it. Basically, I'm going to show you how I made this all the way through. And as you can see, it's basically accordioned together. And the stitching isn't holding it together. I did stitch around all of my pages. But in order to make this, let's go through that, okay? We're going to make a smaller one. We're going to use cardstock. Now, I like to use a good quality cardstock because I don't like it to be flimsy, especially when I'm going to paint on it. This has a really good, you know, if you look at it, it's a good feel. It's almost thick like leather. I like it. And it's fun to hold and fun to work with. It's a good feeling in my hand. Now, when I made that, the pages, whoops, were folded this way in half. Now, in order to make a smaller one, we're going to take each of these pages and we're going to cut them in half. I'm actually going to make, I'm going to use 4 pages and I'm going to cut all 4 of these in half for this demonstration. So you can cut them this way, but I don't think that would look good. It would be more like a flip book, you know, with just the top. For this one, we're going to cut directly in the middle. This is 8.5 by 11. So we're going to cut in the middle. I'm going to use my paper cutter. You can cut with scissors, however you want. And once you cut it, I'm going to show you what I do next. But again, I'm not going to go through every step of this. I'm going to show you what I did to make it. But before I do any cutting, any folding, anything, I take all of these pages first and I'm going to decorate them. Now, you can decorate them however you want, smear paint on them. You can use markers, watercolors, however you want to do it. For me, I like to use my gel press, my jelly plate, you know, to press on some stuff. It makes it a lot quicker and it gets some interesting layers. I will be using the TCW new stencils. As you know, I'm a brand ambassador, so I have a full set of them. So again, I'm just going to let the video run. I'm going to go through the process of what I did with these 4 pages. And hopefully you guys will get motivated to make your own. Okay, so for now, this is done. I don't know if you can see the stitching. Kind of just left the threads hanging. But I did different stitches. Because this is so small, I couldn't do the sides here, the bottom and the top. But I did stitch it, and I don't think it's going to go anywhere. As you can see, there's no cover on it yet, because that's going to be a separate video. I'll make the covers probably this week, and I'll put out a second video. But I hope you guys try this. It was really fun. And this is the one I made yesterday. And as you can see here, the stitching goes all the way through it. That's upside down. But, yeah, I started playing in this one. This is a little bigger. This is just that 8.5 by 11 folded in half and then lined up. But I stitched all the way around the sides. I didn't stitch this page because I'm going to make a cover. And as you can see, I did different stitching on each turn. So it's just something unique and different. And this is a doodle journal, a paint journal, a sticker journal, a mark journal. Use it for whatever you want. But I hope you'll try this easy idea. And like I said, these are pretty strong. So I think that it'll be easy and fun and very durable. So I hope everybody will try them. And thanks for watching.